In this week's Space Startup News, Intuitive Machines submits Moon Rover proposal to NASA. Intuitive Machines has put forward its bid for the next phase of NASA's Lunar Terrain Vehicle contract, competing against Venturi Astrolab and Lunar Outpost. The LTV program is looking for an unpressurized rover to help astronauts in navigating and exploring the lunar terrain. The LTV is called Moonracer. It's anticipated that NASA will announce the award by the end of the year. The Moonracer rover has spent the last year being designed, built, and tested in various environments. Late last year, a prototype vehicle was tested at the Meteor Crater National Landmark in Arizona. The vehicle was tested during the day and night on its ability to traverse obstacles, map terrain using LiDAR, and collect samples. Human-in-the-loop testing was conducted at NASA's Johnson Space Center last year, where astronauts gave feedback on usability, leading to improvements with entering and exiting the vehicle and improved storage of equipment. The PDR, or Preliminary Design Review, was completed in May 2025. Validating Moonracer systems worked with the required level of safety, performance, and durability needed for operating near the Moon's South Pole. Intuitive Machines plans to deploy Moonracer using its own Nova-D lander, an upgraded version of the Nova-C landers used in previous missions, which faced challenges remaining upright after landing. The rover is equipped with a trailer for carrying additional equipment or samples, and can operate autonomously, enabling tasks such as terrain mapping, sample collection, and scientific experiments without a crew present. The company positions Moonracer as a comprehensive surface mobility solution, capable of providing up to 10 years of rover services, not only for NASA, but also for other space agencies and private entities. NASA is expected to announce the LTV contract winner by the end of 2025. Okay, on to our second news story this week. Impulse Space reports high demand for geosynchronous rideshare program. A year ago, Impulse Space, a startup developing a space tug for last mile delivery of payloads, announced a rideshare program for geosynchronous orbits. Impulse says the demand is strong enough they're planning annual missions. The company has built a high-energy orbital transfer vehicle named Helios. The initiative designed to serve the growing number of micro GEO spacecraft with a mass of 1 ton or less. Tom Mueller, founder and chief executive of Impulse Space, said, "We're going to gauge the demand and see if it's real," unquote. 12 months later, Impulse has verified the demand is real. Their geosynchronous rideshare service, named Caravan, uses the Helios space tug launched atop a Falcon 9 rocket. Each mission can carry up to 4 tons of payload. The first mission, Caravan 1, is scheduled for the third quarter of 2026 and is fully booked. Caravan 2 will follow in 2027 and Caravan 3 in 2028. Payloads are deployed into geosynchronous orbits 8 hours after launch. In comparison, large communication satellites with electric propulsion can take months to arrive on station. After deployment, Impulse moves Helios into a higher graveyard orbit and deactivates it to ensure a safe disposal. The Caravan program is modeled on SpaceX's popular rideshare missions for satellites going to low Earth orbit, including the same form factors and attachment ports. An Impulse Space spokesman said, "Essentially, if you are designing your spacecraft for the SpaceX rideshare program today, it is more than likely that you are going to be compatible with ours," unquote. From contract signing to launch, the process typically takes 18 to 24 months. Impulse Space offers transparent pricing based on payload mass, though specific figures were not disclosed. The company claims its pricing is highly competitive for direct-to-GEO services. Okay, on to our last story this week. Axiom Space update. In a recent post on the X platform, Axiom Space said, "The first to the final weld on Axiom Station's payload power and thermal module took the Thales Eleni team only about 250 days. Agile development methods and modular architecture design allowed Axiom Space to revise its station assembly sequence, prioritizing PPTM to meet the needs of the nation and global customers," unquote. The module's pressure vessels are now under construction, with preparations underway to connect the aft and forward sections, conduct flight certification tests, and transport the module shell to Houston for systems integration. In addition, Axiom recently posted a video of the last 100 days, which gives us a good summary of their recent activities. The Axiom 4 private astronaut mission to the International Space Station concluded recently. It was the first time that Indian, Polish, and Hungarian astronauts worked on the International Space Station. This shows how private astronaut missions can broaden space travel across many countries. Vast Space plans to compete with Axiom Space for private astronaut missions to the ISS. This development will provide valuable experience in crew operations, supporting Vast Space efforts to develop its own space station, Haven 1, set for launch in May 2026. Axiom Space is also contributing to NASA's Artemis program by developing advanced lunar spacesuits. The company has partnered with Oakley, a leader in eyewear design, to support Axiom in providing the best optical performance for their suits, ensuring astronauts are well prepared for missions on the moon and beyond. Axiom Space is working on many important space activities, from astronaut missions to validating their spacesuit for Artemis and the construction of their Axiom Space Station as a possible replacement for the ISS. What are you most excited about in space this week? Leave your thoughts and opinions in the comments section below. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this space news video, consider buying me a coffee to help fund more episodes like this. The link is in the description. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. The live stream is a great way for you to share your thoughts and opinions on the videos I posted this week or on any space topic in general. I highlight the most thought-provoking comments on videos I received, along with late-breaking space news and previews of upcoming content. If you've got the time, please tune in and say hi. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.